Over the past 18 months, the 988th Military Police Company has been very busy. Not only did they just return from a tour in Iraq, in the coming weeks they are packing up the entire company and moving to Fort Leonard Wood, Missouri, where they will make their new home. The move is an Army effort to form new battalions called Maneuver Enhancement Battalions, which include not only military police, but engineers and chemical MOSs as well, ready to deploy at the drop of a hat.
Columbus has been a great community. It's a great military town. And Fort Benning is an amazing installation. But we're going to another great town and another great installation to fall under a new maneuver enhancement brigade. So there's a gain, a good and a bad. Of course, the soldiers love the area and are sad to be leaving, but we're all excited about starting our new role in Missouri.
At a ceremony recently at Freedom Hall, the 988th not only cased their guide on in preparations for their move, they also received a new first sergeant and a brand new commander as well. The ceremony kicked off welcoming their new first sergeant, First Sergeant Tony Gifford, who came all the way from Fort Leonard Wood, Missouri, to accept this great new responsibility.
It can be overwhelming, but exciting at the same time. I see a great future in the soldiers that are moving to Fort Leonard Wood, and I can see that once we get them there, we'll be able to build into another great unit and become the great 988 that everybody knows about.
After First Sergeant Gifford was handed his new responsibility and stepped into the role as the first top-breaking NCO of the new 988th, it was then Captain Jeremy Prince's turn to step up, accept the guide on, and take on the responsibilities of moving the company into the future.
Soldiers of the 988th, I look forward to working with all of you as we begin a new page in the illustrious history of this company as we move forward to Leonard Wood. 988th Military Police Company, Thunderstruck, on the watch.
The 988th MP Company has been serving and protecting Fort Benning since 1966. We wish them luck as they move forward to better serve our Army, and although they will be tremendously missed, Fort Benning is used to their absence since they are such a highly deployable unit. Matt Gallup, Fort Benning TV.